please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Midcap Radar. I'm Sumaira Abdi. With me, my colleague Prashant Nair will be joining us in just a bit. Well, the markets have taken a turn for the worse now at the low point of the day. And look at the way that secular fall can be seen on that graph through the day today. So now about 280 points down on the Sensex. The Nifty is down about 100 points at the moment. And look at the Midcap Index. That has been under selling pressure through the day today. And that continues to worsen as well. So now about 300 points gone on that index, and a lot of individual names, getting absolutely battered. Banking stocks, what a day it's been for them. One thought that there would actually be some bit of relief coming through post RBI announcing measures to boost liquidity, but the banking stocks seem perhaps no positive today. Global cues, I mean, the way Brent has risen, all of those factors continue to weigh on our market. Prashant, good afternoon.
Sumaira, hi. I mean, so this is pretty dramatic, right? 92 points, no new triggers, nothing, except, of course, that news that that IRNFS meeting is being kind of called off. Is that the reason? Is it news that, an NBFC has been able to raise money from the market, but at higher rates, I mean, actually substantially higher rates as compared to the beginning of the month. I mean, it could be potentially a bunch of these things together. Oil is up again on the move. So it's sort of starting to weigh pretty seriously at this point. By the way, I mean, a couple of hours back, the Nifty was just down about 30 points, 35. At 11:30, we were down about 30, 35 points or so. We are down 90. So 60 additional points over the last 2 hours. Coming through. So this is a large, large cut. HDFC down, contributing 13 index points, ICICI Bank 11, Reliance 10, Axis Bank 8. It's mostly financials. On the other side, it's IT, Infosys and TCS, State Bank of India, Asian Paints. But I mean, very small and very few number in terms of gains, which we are seeing. So let's just kick the show off with the top stories. Markets, of course, is the top story. It's at the day's low on higher crude oil prices, weak global cues. Banking stocks are dragging. Mid-cap index is under heavy selling pressure.
Short-term yields fall 30 to 40 basis points after the Reserve Bank announces fresh liquidity-infusing measures. Banking stocks, though, remain under pressure.
Customs duty on washing machines and air conditioners, refrigerators and compressors are increased. This is negative for stocks like Voltas and Havells. Titan sees a relief rally as import duty on gold has remained unchanged.
Customs duty hike on aviation turbine fuel weighs on airline stocks, acts as a further headwind to a weaker rupee and higher crude prices.
NBFCs like Indiabulls Housing, Canfin Homes, Edelweiss, Shrey Infrastructure, Reliance Capital and Repco Home Finance take a further beating as investors fearful of growth impediments. All right, Ashwani is back with us at 11:30. He described what was to come as brutal, and he was asking viewers to prepare for it. Ashwani, this would qualify as brutal. Afternoon.
You wanted it brutal, you got brutal.
I didn't want brutal. I was just saying there's too much of brutal happening now. So we need something soft now. Yeah.
See, the issue was that at about 11, NBFC suddenly collapsed. Once, one part of the financials collapse, it's very easy to extrapolate it. And around that time, the bank Nifty also started to collapse. Now, the issue here is that I'll be very surprised if in 3 days' time, the pullback is over and we start making new lows. So while this looks brutal and bad and et cetera, I would think that maybe at about 10,900, 950, you will find support. And maybe market will do another excursion on the upside. This time, maybe not get past 11,050, 70 thereabouts. So my sense is that don't take this as extrapolation of what will happen tomorrow. So being short at 11 and covering right now is a good trade to do, because my sense is that there is more sideways left because the market is still way oversold to begin a fresh down move. The other point is that right now what you can do is India Bulls Real Estate you can sell with a stop of 105, target of 97. BOB is a sell with a stop of 109, target of 102. And Chennai Petro is a buy with a stop of 272, target of 284. Stay away from being long on financials, be it NBFC or any others. Overall, you shouldn't be long, and specifically on these financials, you shouldn't be long. The odd IT stock will go up, etc. But the way, you know, rupee and, you know, crude and all these things are shaping up, those are really hiding places. I mean, don't try to buy because the market trend is very strongly down.
Ashwani, when you think about what could sort of reverse or lead to very sharp bounces, what comes to mind is government action or maybe something from the RBI. We've seen small bits and pieces announced here or there. When they were announced at that point only, I think at least the market realized that this is not going to have any impact. And it has not had any impact. The market direction continues. It's possible the market or the regulator sort of, you know, comes together, comes up with a comprehensive kind of a policy. I mean, it's happened before. And then you see a bit of a blast higher. Would you rate that as a risk or no?
Can the government bring down oil prices? Can the government, beyond a point, hold 73 on the rupee? This is a macro problem. Last 2 years, we enjoyed soft macros. Now the macros are turning. And everything that enjoyed low rates and low, better macros is now facing a particular headwind. So you can, you know, engineer these pop-ups. One day, you know, PNB gets extra money. Next day, import duties. But all this is drop in the ocean. The big push, the big macro wind is right now against us. And as you can see that even after big falls, you can't get even a 200-point bounce. So that just shows that people who are overweight on these NBFCs, financials, banks, etc., they are just becoming underweight. And how long will it take for them to become underweight? Possibly, you know, in years' time, when, you know, most portfolios will be cleaned out of banking financials, like at some point, IT was totally cleaned out. So that is when this thing ends.
No, I mean, I was absolutely, it makes sense. The only thing is, if you're trading, you want to be, not taken out by these engineered pops, and some of them could be large. So that's all. But for now, it's down and down. 76, 77 odd points lower. 10,977 is where we are at. And a small uptick coming through at this point, but nothing much of any consequence at all. So that's where we stand. You look at India Bulls housing, it's basically back down 6%. 946 or so is where that one stands at. But I think we've got some guests joining us from Edelweiss's Corporate Day. Sumaira?
So what we'll do is we'll take a very quick break now when we come back. Hi, welcome back. You're with Midcap Radar. Let's focus on the Edelweiss Corporate Day today. We're discussing the chemical space. Rashesh Gogri, the Vice Chairman and MD of Aarti Industries, and Rohan Gupta of Edelweiss, who tracks this space, now join in. Gentlemen, good afternoon to both of you. Mr. Gogri, I'm going to come to you in just a bit, sir. But first, just an overview from Rohan. Rohan, specialty chemicals have been all the rage, and you'd know that better than anyone. What's the reception they're getting now at an investor meet like this? Is there still a lot more scope for growth, for expansion from here on?
Yeah, hi, Sumaira. Good afternoon. Yeah, you are absolutely right that specialty chemicals, the space which has been attracting the investors' eyes from quite long time. And no doubt that sector has not disappointed any investors who have invested in these companies. All set of companies actually have been benefiting from the opportunities which are flowing from China. And very recent, the currency depreciation also is in their favor. So unlike some other companies who are negatively affected from the currency, thankfully, this is the one sector which is definitely positively impacted by the currency depreciation. The opportunity, I believe, are enormous for India because China is continuously seeing plant closed down because of the pollution norms which they are tightening there. And I think that the opportunity will continue to offer in India, and there is still enough scope for these specialty chemical companies to make a good return for the investor over long run.
Right. Mr. Gogri, you've seen, you know, the quarter gone by has been quite good, sir. What's the, you know, big trigger now that you see for the year? And where are you hoping that FY19 would take you?
Yeah, we have given earlier the guidance on FY19 that we will have a 20 to 25% profit jump from last year. And we have seen opportunities, as rightly said by Ronak, that the chemical market in India is growing significantly on back of Chinese demand. And overall, I think Indian industry, even in space of agrochemicals and dyes, intermediates, there is a buzz of activity which is happening in India. And we, being an intermediate player, we are supporting all our Indian consumers in delivering the products to them so that eventually they can supply these products for the global demand. So overall, we see a healthy situation for chemical industry going forward.
Rohan, what would remain the top picks for you in the area?
So, Sumera, we are looking this sector that the companies who have higher dependence on global markets, I mean, who are exports heavy, those companies are likely to benefit more than the just domestic Indian companies. So a company like Aarti Industry is having almost 50% of their business coming from exports. They also have a very well diversified product basket, so that company is a very strong beneficiary of this opportunity, followed by SRF. That also have a very strong portfolio of refrigerant gases and specialty chemicals, have invested very heavily in the last 2 to 3 years in specialty chemical space. So we believe that SRF is also a strong beneficiary. Even PI Industry, which definitely is an agrochemical player, but they have almost 55% of their business coming from CSM, and that that business offers a growth opportunity for PI CSM business. So I will say that all these companies, Aarti, SRF, and PI Industry, will be definitely on a beneficiary side from this opportunity, and we remain very positive on all these companies.
Right. Okay. Any other top ideas there, Rohan?
Yeah, so definitely, I mean, chemicals is a space which where tail goes very long in India, and there are many, many companies even in a smaller space and all which are definitely beneficiary. We believe even the agrochemical is one sector which is likely to benefit because we are seeing that on one side there is a stable demand, and the companies have a backward integration scope in the country. So company like Insecticide India, Rallis India, and even PI Industry, which is also in agrochemicals, these are the companies which are beneficiary from all these opportunities. There are, in our conference, there are 10 companies participating, and the mood on the conference of the investors in terms of, though the market, I understand, is slightly weak today, but as well as the chemical conference goes, I think that we are hearing a positive commentary from all the companies who have participated in our conference, whether it's the CI Industry, Sharda CropChem, Aarti Industries, Deepak Fertilizers. So all these companies are giving a very positive commentary about their business outlook over next 2 to 3 years.
All right, Mr. Gogri, Rohan, thanks very much for joining in. So that's the word coming in from the two people who are actually in that the specialty chemical space. And of course, you know, Prashant, that's a space that has created so much wealth already. And, you know, they sound pretty confident, actually, that the going in the future could be good as well. Let's take a quick break.
Okay, welcome back. So we've got the market, which is right there. It's not selling off more, 70 points. It was looking pretty easy on the downside, and like a clean, sharp sort of gash, but it's not becoming larger, thankfully. There is a small bounce, but not really building on that as well. Liberty Shoes is on our radar. I mean, there are two items to discuss. One, of course, is the fact that import duty on footwear has gone up. The second, of course, is company-specific, which is the fact that Liberty is entering the lifestyle segment. Let me bring in the management at the company to talk about both these issues. Adesh Gupta is CEO of Liberty. He's with us. Adesh, thanks very much. Great to have you here. First up, I mean, this is the import duty is good news, one reckons. Can you throw some light on this?
Thank you, Prashant. It's indeed a good news for the Indian companies, especially who are in Make in India program, because on behalf of CFLA, which is the Council for Domestic Industry, we have been fighting with the government on the import duty issues, because a lot of cheap and under-invoiced Chinese imports are coming to India to the tune of 25 crores of shoes from China. And we have been harping with the ministry to impose heavier duties so that we are able to make in India a successful program for manufacturing sector. I think it's indeed a good news for companies in India.
So any rough estimations in terms of whether this is what is the import market right now at? What are the domestic? Just give us the big numbers, really. What are the size of the domestic market? How much of that is imports right now?
See, the domestic.
Yeah.
Yeah. The domestic market is, close to about 50,000 crore, which is only a guesstimate because hardly any data is available. But this is based on, assumptions, because we have 125 crores of people. So if you even if you spend 200 rupees or 400 rupees, you can calculate the amount which can come into, the number of volumes or value. However, the silver lining is that, when we have seen the last budget, even the duty was increased from 10 to 20% on imports, for footwear. And now further it has been enhanced to 25. So automatically the government has realized that, it is important that, the Make in India is a successful program. And it is also important for the domestic players especially to, enhance their capacities and also to see that the demand which is going to increase with the introduction of GST, when, the organized players will be getting much more, let's say, value and volume. I believe that it is going to be a game changer for the industry, because as imports becoming expensive, not because of the duty itself, but also the dollar has moved up to 70 to 73 level. And if dollar goes further up, I think it's a boon to the domestic industry, so that they are able to compete with China in a much bigger way.
What,
as I said earlier, we are importing about 25 crores of shoes from China alone.
Yeah.
So I think, this can be a dampener for importers when they have to pay a higher duty and also the higher amount of dollars, value was a rupee. So I think it's a good sign for the sector.
Right. So about 10% of this 50,000 crore would be made by imports right now, as of now, approximately.
The dichotomy is that the real value is unknown, because most of the Chinese imports are coming into India. They are under invoiced to a very great extent. So, that is one of the reasons that we are not able to quantify the real value, though the official value we know. So that is, where the dichotomy is. But I believe it can be, even 20% in terms of, the market size.
Okay, fair enough.
It's 10,000 crore in MRP value.
Okay. Mr. Gupta, now tell us about your lifestyle plans, for Liberty. What segments will you get in briefly?
Well, the first and foremost, I think, Liberty Shoes Limited, which is the flagship company of our group, we have strategized to enter into a new business vertical, completely new business vertical, which is will be called as Liberty Lifestyle Vertical. And it's an SBU within the company, so that we are able to, move on to the growing changes in the lifestyle segment, particularly the new millennials or Generation Z. And what we have done is that we are trying to create a complete new vertical where the entire ecosystem at the front end and back end will be completely new. So we are not going to use the existing Liberty infrastructure for shoes. So we are creating a complete new infrastructure of, the agencies, the human resource, the front end, which is the distribution or the retail. It will be a complete new game altogether.
Okay. Have you decided which segments you'll be in to begin with?
Well, the first and foremost, what we have decided that amongst all categories of lifestyle, we have chosen fine fragrance and perfumes, which will be our first introduction. And, depending on the success, then we will move forward and add on more new items. But I would like to mention here very clearly that, perfume is going to be our core business. And it is a, high margin business. Plus also, the top line can be very important from the company's perspective. But more important is the bottom line.
the importance of this sector is very, very well understood, because this sector or this particular product does not have huge, you know, inventory issues or supply chain issues or size, fashion, and so on. So all the complexities of the footwear is not there in perfume business. And while we are introducing this lifestyle category of 12 perfumes, 6 for men, 6 for women, which are, we are trying to, you know, create a new identity, new logo, and new complete, you know, let's say consumer segment we are going to attack. So we are using an omni-channel strategy where, you know, the select Liberty outlets in India, as well as the e-commerce strategy, as well as the large format strategy of stores, which are, you know, in the marketplace. So we are going to cover the entire gamut of, you know, lifestyle business,
yeah,
or lifestyle retail. And that is the whole idea of getting into the marketing side.
Mr. Gupta, unfortunately, we are out of time. I mean, new foray, lots of questions. I can think of 10 other questions to ask you, but we are completely out of time. So we'll have you back on another occasion to answer those questions. Appreciate your time here. 73 points lower on the Nifty. We are taking a very quick break. See you on the other side.